The next concept is teaming. You may want to pause the video and do these yourself. Look at the first question now. Total weighs 9 factorial, out of which 3 teams of 3 members each. So 3 factorial into 3 factorial into 3 factorial. But then imagine the 3 teams are identical. If these are the 3 teams, if these 3 guys come here and these 3 guys come here, it's not a new case. But in this case, the 2 have been taken as 2 different cases. So this entire answer should be divided by 3 factorial because the 3 teams are not unique because they are identical. In size, they are the same. Another way of looking at this would be out of 9 people for the first team, say 3 have been selected. Now 6 remain. So 6C3. Now 3 remain. So the 3 select themselves. And once again, since the 3 teams are identical, they each have 3 members, the entire value should be divided by 3 factorial. Mathematically, the value would be the same. You do it this way or you do it this way. So simply the answer is factorial 9 upon 3 factorial, 3 factorial, 3 factorial, and then an extra 3 factorial, which is important. Look at this one now. 9 factorial. So 2 and 3. Yes, 2 and 3. But then again, see, out of these 4 teams, 3 are identical. So we need to divide this entire expression by another 3 factorial. Why? Because out of these 4 teams, 3 are identical. So upon 3 factorial. If all 4 were identical, then we would have divided the entire value by 4 factorial. 3 teams of 2, 3, 4. So now see, the 3 teams are unique. They have different number of individuals and therefore this is the answer. You don't have to divide this with anything else. And now the last case. See, this is a very interesting question. 9 factorial upon 3 factorial, 3 factorial, 3 factorial. And although the teams have equal number of members, since they have to work on different projects, so there are 3 projects A, B and C and there are 3 members working on each. Now if these guys swapped positions, these 3 guys working on project C and these 3 guys working on project A would be a new case, and therefore now we should not divide this value by anything. This is very much the answer. So very interesting concept this. Please watch this part of the video once again and attempt these 4 questions. I would say only 1% of the students are able to solve all the 4 questions on this slide in the first go. So please watch it once again. This was the concept, guys. GMAT shorts are deliberately kept brief. For an elaborate explanation, please refer the stage 1 videos. Thanks for watching.